Is calling factory farming the animal Holocaust a bit too extreme? Isn't it offensive to Jewish people comparing animals to humans? Or are people just being overly dramatic? Well, welcome to another controversial episode of Arjuneus Talks. This topic was requested by Vegansingh after he noticed a bunch of Karens getting offended from my last music video, This Is Hallowcaust, which is a spinoff of This Is Halloween. So you can probably already guess which side I'm going to take on this issue. And shout out to Vegan Voicers for this t-shirt.
Oh wait, but Arjuneus, that could only mean that you're a neo-Nazi anti-Semitist. Dislike.
Hold up. It's going to be for shocking reasons that you have probably never heard of, but will remember forever. So let's just hurry up and begin. So I'm just going to go lawyer mode and just start out with the definition of the word Holocaust, and then maybe one day we can move on to numbers and letters, kids. But seriously, we need to start out with the basics because sometimes we rely too heavily on context and the way people use words to define words rather than getting the definition straight from the source. So dictionary.com states that Holocaust has four distinct definitions. Now, right off the bat, you should notice that three out of the four definitions does not involve Jews. And take note that the introduction of the word to the English language dates back to the 1200s, which is way before the Jewish Holocaust. But more on this later. The one definition that does involve Jews refers to it as a historical event, the Holocaust with a capital H as opposed to a lowercase h. So if the Holocaust is different than Holocaust, then the word Holocaust doesn't belong to a particular group, now does it? Now, which of these four definitions of Holocaust do you think the term animal Holocaust refers to? Yeah, you got it, even though you didn't say anything. Definition four, any mass slaughter or reckless destruction of life.
Wait, but Arjuneus, why can't you just use the word animal genocide?
Because domesticated animals don't fit the specific definition of a racial, political, cultural group like us humans do. Okay, well now we established that it is okay under definition four of Holocaust to use the term animal Holocaust without inviting any comparison to Jews. But how about those crazy animal rights activists that make direct comparisons between Jews and animal agriculture? Okay, so this is where it's getting a little bit ridiculous, because this isn't about comparing a particular group to animals, because as a human, you would probably prioritize a human life over an animal. Unless it's my dog. Pick my dog. Just kidding, but listen, this is about empathy. It's about learning from historical events that we are already familiar with. What happened to the Jews was horrible. Most of us have read about the horrors in the history books and, of course, Anne Frank's diary. But what I find most surprising is that these horrible systems used to exterminate the victims of the Holocaust were directly learned and replicated from the systems that we had already been using on animals, from using transport trucks, concentration camps, gassing, shooting, burning, and dumping bodies. Yet when we do that to animals, we're supposed to call it factory farming. That's for sure a euphemism. I'm willing to bet you in the future that our history books are not going to be calling it factory farming, especially once the practice of meat eating will eventually get canceled. In fact, you want to know something crazy? They didn't even call the Holocaust a Holocaust until decades later. It was initially called a genocide, and the term genocide was specifically coined to describe this Nazi extermination. It was only once other groups started using the term genocide for their historical tragedies that some people got offended and felt a need to differentiate the Jewish genocide from all the other genocides, so they renamed it the Holocaust in the 1980s. Just look at how the Western school system really puts an emphasis on the massacre of Jews, but kind of just glosses over the other protected classes that the Nazis exterminated, or glosses over the Pakistan genocide, the Cambodian genocide, and I don't know, maybe the genocide of entire Native American populations in entire continents by colonialists? I don't know, maybe it's a type of white privilege in the history books, or maybe it was because America wasn't the hero in that story, but they were the hero during the Nazi extermination, so they put an emphasis on it. But either way you look at it, it's the same history repeating itself. People are using Holocaust for other groups, and some people are getting offended that vegans dare compare any group suffering with the Jews. Not to mention that the Nazi extermination wasn't exclusively involving Jews, because the Nazis killed thousands of homosexuals, disabled people, and other nationalities during their Holocaust. And on the other hand, there are plenty of Jewish Holocaust survivors that have came forth and directly made comparisons to the institutionalization of animals with what happened during the Nazi regime. I mean, really take a moment to look at all the stuff they have said. Pause the video if you have to. So in conclusion, I think it's completely appropriate to use the term animal holocaust. It occurred before, during, and after the Jewish Holocaust, or any Holocaust for that matter, and is the longest running Holocaust on this earth, with billions of animals exterminated just for being born animal. So this has absolutely nothing to do with being anti-Semitic, because the term Holocaust isn't reserved for people of the Jewish religion any more than the term genocide is reserved for the Jewish religion. This has to do with empathy. And although empathy is an emotion, it is guided by our reasoning skills with our own suffering in comparison to someone else. So until sentient beings have experienced suffering, they won't be able to vicariously experience suffering in other sentient beings. And that's basically the gist of it. That's just the mechanism of how we can experience empathy. If we're going to shut that off, then we're not going to really be able to empathize. And what better ways to compare it with stuff that we are already familiar and sensitive about? So it does kind of become a responsibility to be looking at stuff we're familiar with and comparing it. Anyways, that's my two cents on it. I hope you enjoyed this video, and be sure to like, comment, and subscribe to my channel if you want to see more content like this. And a huge shout out to all the patrons that have made videos like this possible. So thank you so much, and I hope to see you guys soon. Peace begins on your dinner plate. Chaos out, my people.